Today I'm house hunting on the beautiful Almería coastline in southern Spain.
I'm Ben Hillman, an interior designer and property expert. For the past few years, I've been helping house hunters find their dream properties whilst giving them a little design inspiration too. Today I'll be using all my skills to help house hunters Danielle and Matt, a no-nonsense pair who don't hold back.
I wouldn't be happy if I come here on holiday, let alone to come a couple of times a year.
But also give it to me straight when I'm on the right track.
I would sleep well in this room.
Yeah. Oh, I'm glad to hear it.
I get to visit one of the most luxurious properties on the market with luckily just a view outwards from the bedroom.
Oh, you couldn't be bashful living here, could you?
We have privacy glass right through the whole property.
Are you kidding?
Nah.
Really? Oh my goodness.
But at the end of the day, will I find Danielle and Matt's perfect place in the sun?
It's 10 out of 10.
Really?
Yeah, well, this is what I'm talking about.
Oh, this is what I'm talking about. Danielle and Matt have always dreamt of owning their very own holiday home abroad. And now, with finances in place, the search is on for exactly that, a place that the whole family can enjoy.
Danielle, an accounts manager, and Matt, a plumber, lived together in Kent after meeting 19 years ago at a party.
I was single, he was single, and we got introduced.
I waffled on for a few hours and...
Yeah, you did talk a lot.
Yeah.
You've not spoken as much since.
No, then you gave me your number.
Did I?
You did.
OK. We'll go with that.
The rest is history, yeah.
Yeah.
We just click, yeah. We just get on, don't we?
Yeah, we love the same things.
Drinking, eating,
holiday.
Early nights.
Yeah, in bed by 11.
They have two daughters, 14-year-old Lois and Maisie, who is age 12, and feel now is the perfect time to buy a holiday home. They've chosen Costa Almería even though they've never been there before and have an £80,000 budget to find it. Around a 2.5-hour flight from the UK takes you to Almería in southeast Spain. The area has 125 miles of stunning beaches that attract tourists year-round. For those who want to do more than water sports and sunbathe, the coastline is scattered with historic hotspots like Vera with its fine architecture and the whitewashed hillside town of Majaca Pueblo, as well as nature reserves and rolling hills and a rather dramatic landscape inland to explore.
With a similar climate to the Costa del Sol, the Almería coastline is a great option for those who want year-round sun without the hefty price tag. A two-bedroom apartment here with a communal pool, for example, can cost as little as £35,000.
Before we start the search, I'm meeting Danielle and Matt to find out exactly what they're looking for.
Guys, welcome to Almería.
Thank you.
Happy to be here?
Very happy, yeah.
Because you've never been here before, have
we
you?
We haven't been before, no.
So, begs the question, what are we doing here now?
So we've come to this area of Spain because it's got lovely beaches, it's quite family orientated,
yeah.
So we look forward to bringing the children here.
So you must have done some research, right?
I have done a lot of research,
yeah.
And I ask a lot of friends that have travelled to Spain and sort of where they've been.
What is the idea? Is this literally just purely for family holidays?
Yes.
Or... Right.
Yeah, purely for holidays.
Just us, the kids and yeah, family members.
What are you going to be getting up to then when you're out here?
Just long walks, really, across the beach.
Yeah,
we like to spend a day on the beach.
Yeah.
We like to eat out a lot, don't we?
We do like to try different restaurants. Yeah. Probably a lot of exploring.
Will you be setting sail on the high seas?
Oh, definitely, yeah. Boat trips and I like, yeah. Any excursions to do with the sea, yeah, definitely. During lockdown, me and Lois got into kayaking as well. Bought a couple of kayaks and we go out on the river.
Will you be doing that here, do you reckon?
Yeah, I'd like to get into something like that, yeah.
What are the most important things for you then in terms of like the property that we find? What do you want nearby?
Ideally, we want to be as close to the beach as possible, really. Pool would be lovely. Two bedrooms, I mean, if we could squeeze the three in the budget,
okay.
Three bedrooms would be brilliant. That
yeah.
would really make me happy.
Yeah.
If more of us could come
yeah. okay.
and sleep comfortably.
Yeah.
A nice outdoor space, so when we get back from our day at the beach, we can open the wine and sit on the balcony.
Lovely.
I'd like some sun on the balcony.
Okay.
That's a biggie.
Yeah.
You don't want to be sat there with your coats on.
No, I like the sun, yeah.
I know your budget's £80,000, mm-hmm. isn't it? And you could potentially stretch to how much?
90,000.
To 90, so
maybe
an extra 10.
Teeny weeny bit more.
I think I've got the lowdown on what it is you want.
Yeah.
Are you happy now to go and see some property?
Can't wait.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Come with me.
We're kicking off this search in Palomares. With a population of around 1,600 people, a small town centre with all the basics and a beach of its own, I think Danielle and Matt will really like it here. But as they've never been to this part of Spain before, en route to my first property, I think I need to take them to one of the most popular towns on the whole of Costa Almería.
This beautiful town is called Majaca Pueblo, so we're right up on the hilltop now. What do you think of it?
Lovely.
It's really beautiful. Nice, yeah. Nice and relaxing to sit and have a coffee and have views.
You'd come up here, would you?
Definitely would.
For a cheeky little coffee?
Yeah, I would.
We are actually a 20-minute drive from the first property, but I thought this would be a lovely place to bring the friends and family.
Yeah, to bring friends and family. It's a really interesting, picturesque place.
It's quite individual, it's quite unique. Because back in the 60s, it was mostly derelict. And then the mayor at the time incentivised people to move here by offering them land for free if they renovated the houses. Mm. So it became a bit of like an arty community. Yeah. The amazing paving everywhere as well.
Yeah. Very slippery for high heels.
But... Well, look, this beautiful tree that we've stood under now is quite magnificent, isn't it? That's a laurel tree.
It's a laurel tree.
Better not rest on it, come on.
My first property is around 9 miles away on the outskirts of Palomares. The market here is booming at the moment, with house prices rising around 5% over the last few years. So I've had to push into their wiggle room, but I can't wait to see what they make of it.
Right, stopping you there because we're in Palomares, less than a mile from the beach.
Oh, really?
Yeah, that's handy. Yep. Lovely to walk to the beach.
All right, let's talk about the property because it's in there somewhere. It's 50 apartments. What do you think of it from the outside?
I'm not loving the outside.
Hang on a minute. What do you not like? What's not working here?
Oh, yeah, it does look a little bit commercial, industrial almost, yeah.
Yeah, it needs a bit of greenery, a few palm trees.
Isn't that industrial vibe what everyone's after these days?
Maybe. In Shoreditch.
Yeah. For me, this is kind of like a modern take on the Moorish vibe. So a bit fortified from the outside, but once you get in, nice big open courtyard, things completely change. OK, and I'm going to be showing you a two-bedroom, two-bathroom, loads of outside space. Forget six people outside. Let's say 60 people outside.
Brilliant.
Right next to the pool as well. Now I've told you all about it, what do you think?
It sounds a lot more interesting the other side.
It's on the market for £82,500.
It's not bad.
Although I think we could probably negotiate just a little bit on that.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
Now do you want to see it?
Yeah.
That's more like it. Come on.
Well, I'm trying my best to convince them, but I'm hoping the communal pool will help with that. And the outside space that comes with the apartment could persuade them too, as there's a large covered patio to the front and an absolutely huge terrace at the back. A total sun trap that wraps around the side and has views over the surrounding countryside. Inside is an open plan living area with a kitchen in the corner. There are two bright bedrooms, a shower room and a bathroom.
Right, this is the one we're going to see next to the pool. Now, how about this for your terrace? Good size?
Yeah, not bad.
Good, good, good. Just like you asked for.
Yes, the terrace is a lovely size. Mm. It just seems
not
to be
pointing the sun as much
lacking
as we'd
sunshine.
Like.
Yeah.
Teasing a little bit because there's an even bigger terrace out the back. That's kind of when it gets too hot in the summer.
Yeah, it's
when you go to cool down.
In disguise, yeah.
You will need it, I'm telling you now. But what do you think of the living space in the kitchen in here?
The kitchen area seems a little bit too smallish.
Does it?
Yeah.
Little L shape. How much kitchen area would one need on a holiday when one's eating out all the time?
Most evenings.
It's not doing it for me at the moment, to be honest. It's just that there's something, yes.
Yeah, I'm not feeling it. I don't walk in and think, oh, I love this, but I see there is potential to it.
Let me show you more this way. Now, this, in my book, is where things get really good.
This is better,
yeah.
Oh,
yeah, this is lovely.
Yeah?
Really nice, yeah.
Oh, look at the size of it. It goes all the way down the side of the property.
Oh, I'm shocked.
It's a lot greener
really
as well, yeah.
I'm shocked.
It's lovely.
Really
lovely.
Like
There's
it.
Some nice barbecues
I'm
out
impressed.
Here.
I'm impressed.
Oh, yes.
We could do everything out here. Barbecues, parties, sunbathing.
Field of lettuce, uninterrupted views down to the sea.
That even has a fruit tree.
Yeah. Was that something you were after, was it?
It was, yeah.
Tick.
There we go. Fruit trees, views, tons of outdoor space.
You know what? This is really nice. I really like it.
I mean, you're coming to Spain to live outdoors, effectively, aren't you, when you're on holiday? Yeah. So you're probably going to spend much more time here than you are in that living room anyway. Mm. All good things to think about. I'm going to let you go back inside, have a good look around.
Thank you.
I'll see you when you're done. See you in a moment. That was a much better reaction than the walk up to the property and the living room. Will they like it once they've seen the rest of it? Let us see.
So this seems a little bit small for my liking. I also have the window out onto the terrace. Yeah, I'm not really keen on the bedroom size, as this is the main bedroom. I mean, it looks fairly new, quite modern.
Do have maybe an island in the kitchen or something like that.
I think it needs something to separate it from the room. Yeah, it's not really ideal.
It's been up and down with this Palomares apartment on the market for £82,500. I wonder which way it's going to end up.
Here they come.
Here they come.
You liked the back terrace?
Loved the back terrace.
Has that changed things for the inside of this place?
The layout of the kitchen is still...
That's bugging you?
Bugging us, yeah.
Yeah.
Ah. Is this a contender, though?
I don't know. I think I'd think about it.
We're going to stick it on the back burner.
Yeah,
at the moment.
I think so,
okay,
yeah.
And we'll try and get the layout spot on with the next property.
Yeah, that would be good.
Come on.
To try and find them that, I'm taking them around 2.5 miles up the coast to Verda, a small yet rather lovely town. I've lined up a property on a complex half an hour's walk from the beach. But before I take them to see it, though, I want to show them around a bit first.
Now, this stunning old town square. It's Verda Old Town. What do you think?
It's lovely, really nice.
Very picturesque.
It's gorgeous,
history.
Isn't it?
It is lovely.
So will you be visiting places like this, do you think?
Yeah.
For sure, yeah. I mean, it's nice to have a day out and do something different. Yeah.
Nice atmosphere of all the bars and cafes.
Is this somewhere the girls would be interested in coming to?
Yes, they would. I'd say more the eldest one. She's more into historical things, isn't she, and learning that history of a place.
Yeah, absolutely, and tons of history here, as you can see, with this beautiful old church and the old town hall. But they're lovely sort of style buildings, aren't they, with this kind of sandstone.
They are really nice.
Whatnot.
It'd be nice to see it of an evening, all lit up as well.
Oh, my gosh, yeah, definitely. And this place does come alive. There's a number of events, like, throughout the year, but one in particular, which is in September, which is the patron saint of the town, which is Saint Cleopas. So there's music, there's dancing, there's food.
Okay.
But that would be great, because then you get to see a bit of real Spanish life.
Yeah, that sounds nice. We'll put that one in the diary.
Yeah, oh, well, there you go. Fantastic. The house we're going to see isn't here, but this would be your closest large town with all the conveniences, bars and restaurants, cafes, banks, pharmacies, all that kind of stuff. I actually feel a bit like your tour guide at the moment.
Yeah, I'm not paying
you. Because you've not been here before, have you?
No, we haven't.
I feel like I should be holding an umbrella up in the air. Anyway, this way. Follow me. Come on. Follow the umbrella. Actually, no, it's this way. Coming up, I can't wait to find out what Danielle and Matt make of my next property, a stylish ground floor apartment with its very own front garden. Today I'm on the beautiful Almería coast in southern Spain, helping Matt and Danielle to find their perfect holiday home. And after a somewhat lukewarm start with my first property, it's time to turn the temperature up on this search.
They can't wait to spend family holidays here, mainly on the beach, with their two daughters, Maisie and Lois. And they have a maximum budget of £90,000 to find their dream home. And while they definitely like the outside space that came with my first property, they wanted a bigger living area and kitchen. Oh, and bigger bedrooms too. So I've taken them to Verda and to a property that is around a half an hour's walk to the beach. The average two-bedroom apartment in and around this town is around £79,000, within budget. So I've pushed things a bit to line up a property on a particularly lovely complex that I think they'll both really like.
Bit different this time. I'm hoping you like it. What do you reckon?
Very different.
Very nice.
Compared to the last one, this is 10 out of 10.
Really?
Yeah.
Same for you?
Definitely, yeah. Love it.
It's sold to me just from the front, to be honest. I really do like it, yeah.
Oh, well,
this is what I'm talking about.
Oh, this is what I'm talking about.
This is more of a holiday home, isn't it?
This is more of a holiday home.
Yeah. For us, anyway, yeah.
Is it the greenery?
The greenery helps. I think the fact they've got some fairy lights along the wall, I do like a fairy light.
Yeah.
And It just seems like a nice, cozy, holiday homely. Yeah, holiday homely.
Do most people use the communal gardens?
They do. This particular development is great for all the communal facilities because you've got three pools.
Oh, there's three?
One's an indoor pool.
Oh, really?
You've got a gym, spa, jacuzzi.
You're selling it to me.
Am I?
You are, yeah.
Because I just think this is almost like the perfect family
setup. It sounds ideal for a family, yeah.
Yeah, it does. It's a ground floor apartment, as you've probably guessed.
Yeah, yeah.
This is a two-bedroom, two-bathroom property. Immaculate inside. Really, really lovely.
Brilliant.
It comes at a price, nice. Okay?
Yeah, of course.
It is pushing your budget. It's just over £91,500.
Okay.
But, you know, everything's negotiable.
Yeah.
Exactly.
We could potentially get it to the very top of your wiggle room, mm-hmm. thereabouts.
To be honest, the price that you've told me, I'd be more than happy with just the outside. But yeah, I'm dying to get indoors. Mm.
To get outside.
Well, what a fabulous first impression. Danielle and Matt are both pretty smitten with this garden and the facilities here. Inside is a brighter and larger open plan living area. There's a separate modern kitchen. The main bedroom is a good size with built-in storage and an ensuite. And the second bedroom is a big double, which would work well for Maisie and Lois. There's a family bathroom too.
Now, hopefully the inside is going to impress just as much.
Nice. Yeah, yeah. I like it.
Yeah?
Yeah. At first I come in and I thought it was a bit narrow.
Mm.
But the more I look around, the more I'm thinking I do kind of like it. The walls are nice and white and fresh, and the floor. Yeah. Do you know if any of the furniture is in with the property, the price?
It's not necessarily included, but you could negotiate some of it in with the price.
I definitely want the light.
Oh, right, OK. That's a bit of a hit,
isn't it? It is. I really, really like the light.
You can see more. Right, so look in the main bedroom, which looks beautifully out to the garden.
It does.
Nice and bright as well, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah. This is nice.
Mm. You've got your built-in wardrobes.
This was a must for me. Yeah.
Was it?
Wardrobes. Yeah. Well, I think if we're going to be leaving a lot of clothes here, we need somewhere decent to store them.
It's just bright, it's cosy, yeah.
Yeah, view of the lovely garden.
Mm, get a good feeling.
I would sleep well in this room.
Yeah. Oh, I'm glad to hear it. Well, look, the girls have got to be happy with their room.
Yes.
As well. Go and check that out. When you're done, I'll meet you outside in the garden.
Brilliant,
lovely,
thank
OK?
You.
I'll see you in a minute.
Thank you.
Well, there you go. I think the whole family's going to be impressed with this place, and I've definitely nailed their style now. What is it? It's holiday homely.
OK, so this will be the girls' room.
This is nice, yeah.
It's really nice. They would be quite happy in here.
Two beds. Perfect.
Yeah, they'd like this.
This is nice.
This is really nice. Yeah, it's bigger than I expected it to be.
It's a lot bigger than the last place. Plenty of room for cooking.
This garden apartment on the market for just over a negotiable £91,500 wowed Danielle the moment she laid eyes on it. So how are they both feeling now they've had a proper look?
Right, how'd you get on in there?
Very, very nice.
Very, very nice. Would you change anything?
I don't actually think I would.
No. Are you making plans for this place? What's going on?
It's looking good so far, yes.
Is it?
Yeah.
We don't want to get you too excited.
Is this going to be a tough one
like
to beat?
I
think so, yeah.
Really? I love it. I'm just wondering now, look, how do we possibly beat this?
Maybe somewhere a little bit nearer the beach.
OK. Good suggestion. I think that's exactly where we should head then. Off to the plier. I'll follow you.
It's so good to have my first contender in the bag. But they did say from the start that the beach was their number one priority. So I'm taking them just an 8-minute drive from here in Vera to Vera Playa. As the name suggests, it's the coastal part of the town with a great selection of restaurants and bars right on the front. It's all just 3 minutes walk from my next property, so I want to stop off at the beach to show them that first.
Here it is, Vera Playa. We're kind of in the sort of like naturey reserve bit.
Very big beach. The Baywatch Tower is a nice addition.
Oh, you like that?
I like that, yeah.
Could be in California, couldn't
could
we?
Could be, yeah.
Oh, yeah. And this, I mean, were you expecting to see flamingos?
No. We weren't expecting to see flamingos.
Well, there you go. I aim to please. But this beach stretches 4.4 miles, so you'll have plenty of space when you come over in the summer, you and the girls. How much time would you spend down here, do you reckon?
I would say we're probably going to come to the beach most days, aren't we? Yeah. Every other day, have a beach day, a pool day, maybe an activity day. But the beach is somewhere we plan to spend a lot of time.
Knowing that you've got kayaks, do you like your water sports then? Because just down, about a mile down the beach is a sailing club, so you can hire kayaks, save you bringing them out. Or you could rent a boat for about £30 an hour and do a bit of sea fishing with the girls, perhaps.
Or sunbathing. You could do the fishing.
I know what you'll be up to. Sunbathing on the bow of the boat, won't you? With a book.
Nice price, really, isn't it, for that sort of thing?
It's something different, isn't it?
Yeah.
Anyway, look, if you do want to try something a bit different, there's a naturist beach just down there.
That's out.
I'm not suggesting you try it, but it is local. And it's it's the biggest in Europe.
Oh, is it really?
It's the largest nature's beach and resort.
I wonder what the family would think if we did it there.
I'm going to send you off to the house. I'm just going to take a stroll down that way. Coming up, will Danielle and Matt fall for the charms of my next property with two lovely pools just a stone's throw from the beach? Today I'm house hunting around stunning Almería in southern Spain with Danielle and Matt. And having just wowed them with my last property, it's time to go one better by heading off to the beach. They are looking for a dream home for family holidays with their daughters where they might go kayaking, but they will definitely be sunbathing. For their maximum budget of £90,000, I blew them away with this garden apartment on a lovely complex in Vera that gave them that homely feel. But holidays for them will involve daily trips to the beach, so the only way to beat it will be to find something even closer to the sea. So, I've taken them to Vera Playa and to a property that is exactly the same price as my last, but this time just a few minutes walk away from the beach. To find them something in this amazing location does mean they'll have to make some compromises. It'll be interesting to see what their priorities are.
Well, here we are, just a few hundred metres from the beach. Beautiful urbanisation. What do we think? Is this comparable with the last pool?
Very nice size.
The surroundings are really lovely here. Think,
yeah,
they
are nice. I wonder how busy it'll get. There seems a lot of apartments here. So
there are actually two large pools on the development, shared by 290 apartments, or properties, I should say, because they're not all apartments. They're houses. Is it as good as the last one?
I like it. I think the last place, I don't know what it is, it sounds silly, but it had a lot of grass around it and it just made it look more appealing.
It's whether these are homely as opposed to holiday lets.
We need to keep in mind here is you can actually carry your kayak to the beach. That has got to be a big selling point, hasn't it?
It has, yeah, because we sort of say, oh, half an hour walk, that's fine, but when you've actually got the children with you and it's steaming hot sun, it's going to be a lot worse than what we're thinking. So, yeah, location-wise, this one probably is a lot better.
Should we go and see the property?
Yeah.
Come on. Now, we've actually approached the property from the back. Now, this is our terraced property, built in a sort of Spanish colonial style. Is it appealing?
It looks pretty from the outside, but I'm getting the feeling it's going to be quite dark inside. It feels a bit shaded.
So you're a little bit nervous, are you?
Yeah.
Oh, really? Oh, no, don't. Don't be nervous.
I can't see a garden either.
Private outdoor space is certainly limited.
Yeah.
Because we are so close to the beach.
Yeah.
So most of your enjoyment out of outdoor space will be at the beach or it will be in the sort of communal gardens. Mm. Are you quite concerned about the fact that, you know, there isn't that much private outdoor space with this?
It's a big factor though, isn't it? Yeah.
Yeah. It's a big thing for us having a nice outdoor space. Mm. But then it is on the beach, so...
Well, I'm still going to hope that this wows you enough inside to change your mind. Now, the price of this, given that it's a two-bed, two-bath, two-storey property in a great location, let's not forget that, it's on the market for just over £91,500. And that is all because of the location, I think. It gives you an idea of, like, location is everything with this property.
Yeah, when you compare to the last.
Yeah, but the agent has said you should be able to get it at the top of your budget.
Okay.
Should we get inside?
I really hope they keep an open mind with this one. And while they are lacking in private outdoor space here, I think it makes up for it with the communal pools. The property itself has an open plan living area with some features that I'm hoping will give Danielle and Matt that homely feel. It's also partly open to a good sized kitchen. Upstairs, the main bedroom leads out onto a lovely balcony. The second bedroom is also bright with views of the grounds, and there's a family bathroom.
All right, starting the living room, which is a little more traditional style, but I think it's got a bit of character and style. What do you reckon?
I don't particularly like it.
I find it very dark from the properties surrounding it, and not a lot of lights getting in.
I'm thinking I wouldn't be happy if I come here on holiday. Let alone to come a couple of times a year.
Where have I gone wrong here? Because I thought, you know, nice open fireplace like that, it's quite charming, isn't it?
If we were going to live here and it was in the winter time, yeah, it'd be nice to have a little log fire going, but no. Yeah, I don't think the kids would like it.
No.
Would they not?
No.
This is not the dream.
No.
We're right by the beach, for goodness sake! I thought this
was... You forget that when you're in here.
Is that what it is?
Yeah.
Do you want to see more of this property, or are you...
I'm not overly fussed.
I don't think if I saw more, I would want to buy it.
This is a no, is it, for both of you?
Yes, please.
OK, yes, please.
Please.
If you're happy, OK, we'll move on from this. We'll draw a line under this property. But for the next one, are you happy to stick close to the beach?
Yeah, definitely. It'd be nice to have a comparison.
Yeah, because, I mean, originally, it was about the beach,
wasn't it?
So let's try and make that work if we can. Yeah. But let's head off. Matt, lead the way. Can't quite believe it, but there you go. It's not for them. I thought it'd be all about location.
But whatever happens, this beach duplex apartment on the market for just over a negotiable £91,500 is a definite no. I'm not going to give up on that beachside dream location just yet, though. I'm taking them a 10-minute drive from here to the outskirts of Mahaka. Before I show them the property, I think I should show off the beach here first.
So we're 4 miles down the coast from our last property and on one of the first beaches as you enter Mahaka. Bit of a different beach to the last one. What do you think of this?
This is lovely. It looks really more like nice. A beach than the nature reserve, but this is beautiful.
Yeah. you say that, but there is a nature reserve over there as well, which is rather lovely. But we've got these beautiful turquoise waters.
Yeah, yeah. They are. We were just saying how turquoise they are.
They're gorgeous, aren't they? But in summer, obviously, it's a really popular beach around here. You've got chiringuitos. Do you know what chiringuitos are? So it's like the Spanish name for beach bar.
All right.
There's one up there. So they open up in the summer. So it's not far to go for a drink, bite to eat.
Yeah.
In fact, I say it's not far to go for a drink and a bite to eat. Next property I'm going to show you is just over the road.
Wow.
So really not far to go for a bite to eat at all.
What could you want?
Should we go see it?
Mahaka is one of the most popular tourist destinations in this area. Demand here is high and so are the house prices. So I've taken them to the outskirts of Mahaka Playa to try and make their money go a little further. I've thrown everything I can at this to get them close to the beach. I've even managed to get a third bedroom. But as they'll see, something will still have to give. Will this be right for them?
Right, another pool.
It's a little bit smaller than the previous pools.
It is.
But it's by the sea.
Oh, we're by the sea. This is what, you know, this is what the compromise. I'm trying to get to grips with.
How many apartments do you use this pool?
You've got about 70 apartments.
Oh, OK.
That's
not
too bad,
Bearable, then.
But bearing in mind, we are so close to the beach.
Yeah. Yes, but I suppose when you come back and you just want to dip in the water, it's ideal, isn't it?
So could you compromise on the size of the pool?
Yeah, I think if the apartment's right, then we would compromise on the size of the pool.
And what about the surroundings, you know, the style of the buildings around here?
They're not doing it for me. I sound really fussy now, but they just don't have enough character for me, I think. It's just very white.
It's a sort of a modern take on that old kind of whitewashed pueblo.
But, I get that. It's just, I feel...
I've shown you a completely different style, which you've fallen for, haven't I?
It's your fault.
Let's go and have a look at it, then. OK, so I'm going to stop you there, because this is the property we're going to look at. A three-bed apartment this time. So I'm thinking, great for the girls as they get a bit older and want their own space, or for the family.
OK.
Does that make a bit of a difference?
It would make a big difference, to be fair.
Again, it is whitewashed on the outside, but you've got a terrace that runs all the way round, effectively, which you could screen a bit if you wanted to make it a bit more private.
Yeah, some greenery and some plants.
Definitely add that greenery. This was on the market originally 7 or 8 months ago at just over £107,500. They have since brought it down in price. Okay. It's now just over £79,000.
Really?
I know.
Wow.
Because literally it's all about location here.
Mm.
Yeah.
That's what you're paying for.
Yeah, it's a good price for being so close to the beach.
Okay.
Yeah, keen to look.
You're keen to look?
Yeah.
I'm glad you're keen
more
to look.
More so now,
I've heard the price.
Oh, yeah, there we go. I'm going to let you have a look around inside on your own and I'll be waiting for you when you come out. See you in a moment.
All right, thanks.
Well, there you go. Right, maybe not quite so favourable from the outside, but I really do feel like they could put their own twist on this place and hopefully it'll be a contender.
This pool is a bit smaller than the others we've seen, but it's still great to have. The apartment also has a large terrace, which is hopefully an improvement on the last property and big enough for Danielle and Matt to relax after a hard day at the beach. Inside is an open plan lounge diner, and there's a separate kitchen. The main bedroom is a good size, and there are two more bedrooms with this property and two bathrooms.
This is the living area. It's got a bad size.
Can't say I like it, to be honest. It's got a nice width. But it's still
a bit modernising, doesn't it?
Yeah, I think we definitely would need to do something with it. This must be the main bedroom. It's got the fitted wardrobes, which I need, but...
It's proper, it just needs a fair bit of work done to it, doesn't
it? It's not got a very good outlook out the window. Decent size. With a bit of work and a bit of paint, I'm sure you can make it your own.
This is the terrace. Quite spacious.
Yeah, it's a nice size.
Just a bit in the shade as well, isn't
it? Yeah, it's not very private.
I don't think this is working for me, to be honest.
No, I don't think so.
This Mahaka Beach apartment on the market within budget at just over £79,000 has a location I know Danielle and Matt will like. But will it be a contender?
Right. Is this search back on track now?
No.
No?
No.
Why not? This are three bedrooms. Come on.
It's not for us.
It's not for you.
No.
Even with the extra room.
Even with the extra proximity
to the beach.
It's not a bad property. I think you could make that your own, but it's just not something.
In comparison with the property too, I think.
We've been shown something too nice.
It's always going to be this dilemma of, do you get something close to the sea, which originally you thought you wanted?
Yeah.
Or do you go a little bit further inland, get more for your money?
I think that's what made us realise that we didn't know exactly what we wanted, and then we've seen something
that's
blown our mind. And,
it's even comparable.
Yeah. We've seen what we want. Why are you still showing me properties? What's this about? With the final property, what do you want to do?
Probably like to see more of what we like.
Really?
For nice looking outside space.
Are you surprised you're saying that? Would you?
Yeah, I really thought that I wanted to be on the beach, near the beach, sort of just a stone's throw. But with our budget, what it seems that we can get by the beach, we're quite happy to go more inland.
Come on, let's head back inland.
Coming up, will my final property give them the best of both worlds?
You can see the sea.
Well, there you go, you can see the sea. Today I'm on Almeria's stunning coast, helping Danielle and Matt to find their dream holiday home. And having discovered that being close to the beach means one too many compromises, there's a lot riding on my final property.
They can't wait to spend family holidays out here, and after seeing four properties for their maximum £90,000 budget, I have one strong contender that they absolutely loved. This garden apartment that gave them both that homely feel. But I think my final property with stunning sea views could give it a run for its money. Before that though, I'm taking a break from the house hunt to visit one of the most luxurious properties on the market in this area at the moment. On for just over £1 million, this five bedroom property was built just 6 years ago and is the ultimate in contemporary design inside and out, with some stunning views down to the sea. I'm meeting agent Stephen, who has agreed to show me around.
This is a bit different, isn't it? Look at this. It's a circular kitchen living space, like properly circular. Love that.
When we had the original house here, we demolished it in order to sink the property down into the valley. And that's how you have the sweeping views, 230 degree.
It's beautiful. It's fantastic. So what was it, like an old house here before?
It was a little villa, two-bed villa. When he had the property designed, he wanted to have it south-facing, but the sea's to the east. So he incorporated this design.
Absolutely sweeping view. Pretty special, isn't it? Do you mind if we pop upstairs and have a look up there?
Yeah.
Let's go. All right. Kidding me, aren't you? Look at those views!
Something else, yeah.
That's ridiculous. Wow, what a bedroom to have. It also goes to show, actually, because it's not a huge room at all as the main bedroom, but it's all about design, good design. You don't need the space, you just need the wow factor, don't you? And my goodness, that has got it.
Waking up to that in the morning.
Yeah. I mean, you couldn't be bashful living here, could you?
But you have privacy glass right through the whole property.
Are you kidding?
Nah.
Really? Oh my goodness. Down to every last detail.
Every single thing.
I love it. You know where I want to go next though, don't you, Stephen?
Swimming pool.
Down straight, come on.
And you have the pool.
Isn't this glorious? Wow, I mean, you can see why they wanted to build this here. I mean, it's huge.
30 metres and it's heated.
It's heated?
Yeah.
Does it need, I mean, the sun's beating down on it as well. Does it need it?
I don't know, I'm ginger, I'm never interested.
Stephen, thank you so much for showing me around this place. Better get back to my set.
I'll show you.
It's back to the house hunt, and my final property is back in Vera, as Danielle and Matt really liked it there. As they haven't been to this part of Spain before, though, there's one more place I want to show them around before I take them to see it.
Now, somewhere a little bit different, Garrucha town, which is a fab little town, I've got to say.
It does look nice.
It does look lovely, yeah.
Looks a bit more traditional.
This is a proper Spanish working town, steeped in history, lots to do. It's nice because it's a little bit different to Majaca, which is really a resort town.
Mm. It's nice to have a bit of difference, though, isn't it? Don't want the same all the time.
Has it got a good atmosphere for you?
It seems to be.
That big building in the background is actually where they auction off the fish every day. It's completely frenetic, it's a bit mad. Mm. And you can see, you know, the names of the boats, the catches coming in, what fish they're selling. It's just a taste of actual life here, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
But look, it's a lovely town and it is definitely worth spending a bit of time here. But I think it's time to go and see our final property, which is a 10-minute drive away. Come on.
Back inland in Vera, I've lined up a property that I think is very similar in size and feel to my second property, the garden apartment that they like so much. And it's still only half an hour's walk from the beach too. I really hope this will be another contender.
Step this way for our fifth and final property. Ringing any bells?
Yeah, it looks very similar. Straight away when I saw it, I thought, well, we're probably going to like it, yeah, because it definitely does look so similar to the one we
Yeah.
Had.
Is it tugging on the heartstrings at all on the approach?
It is, not so much as number two, but I still like it.
I would say this obviously hasn't been used for a little bit, so it needs dusting off, shall we say that? It needs dusting off, but it's a lovely property. Again, it's a two-bedroom, two-bathroom property, very similar in terms of style inside. The reason I'm showing you this is because of those sea views.
Which you can't see the sea.
You can see the sea.
That's fine.
Does that come with a premium?
Interestingly, not. Asking price for this one is just over £91,500. It's got a couple of outdoor pools, got an indoor pool as well. It's been on the market for 6 to 8 weeks. Has been a lot of interest in this one. They have had one offer, but it's been deemed too low.
Did we know what the offer was?
The offer that was put in was about £83,300.
Okay. Is this something to work on?
It does, but the agent seems to think you get it around the, you know, the middle of your wiggle room, so that £85,000, somewhere in that ballpark.
Yeah.
So there is a bit more flexibility in negotiating with this one than there is with your other favourite.
Yeah, it's definitely something to think about while we're looking around.
Yeah. Fruit tree as well, to boot.
Lovely. Yeah, it's a lemon tree. Our eldest does like hot water and lemon in the morning, so to come out here, chop her up a lemon and put it in a hot water should be really happy.
Your mum's partial to a gin and tonic as well.
When life hands you lemon, make gin and tonic. Come on, inside.
So far, so good. This low-maintenance garden really is lovely, with plenty of space for the whole family. Inside is a good-sized living room, and there's a separate kitchen. The main bedroom has some built-in storage and an ensuite. There's another double bedroom and a bathroom.
Great reaction out there. What do we think of this?
I actually prefer this.
It's really nice, yeah. Yeah.
It seems a little bit brighter in here.
Prefer the layout of the interior of this one compared
feels
to
feels bigger. Mm-hmm. And we've got the two sofas, which I don't know,
it works better, doesn't it?
I like it.
Pretty good, isn't it? It's not bad. Should we go through and see the bedroom? Main bedroom, ensuite shower room, and of course you've got sea views as well.
Yeah, those views are amazing to wake up to, I think.
Yeah, the mountains.
The sun coming up, nice and bright.
You've got your built-in wardrobes that I know you like. You do like them, don't you?
The bed looks bigger than your standard double, and you've still got a lot of room around the edges of it. So, yeah, it's a nice sized room.
I think after the last two properties as well, it's just nice to see you guys excited about, you know, seeing the place again. But you are going to have to come to some decision between the two that you do like, one way or the other. It doesn't feel like there's too much in it at the moment.
I don't know how we're going to... No. We're going to have pros and cons written down, I think, tonight over...
A few lists later on, yeah.
Right, the only way you're going to make your mind up, of course, is going to see the rest of it. So I'm going to let you totter off, and I'll see you in a moment.
Thank you.
There you have it. It's going to be a really, really difficult decision to make, but it might just be a flip of the coin. In my mind, though, this place has got "buy me" written all over it.
Yeah, similar sort of kitchen, isn't it?
Yeah, I think the other one seemed like it had more up this end, didn't it?
The tiles
are
nice.
New units, kitchen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a little bit smaller than the
This could cause a little problem. I'm not sure how we'd fit two single beds in here.
But yeah, it's still a decent size with a wardrobe and nice outlook. Views again, yeah.
It seemed this apartment with sea views on the market for just over a negotiable £91,500 was going to give Danielle and Matt a bit of a dilemma. Is this also going to be in the running?
What do you think about this one?
Definitely a contender, isn't it?
Just need to talk about it and make a decision and weigh up the pros and cons of each one.
Yeah. What are the pros and cons about this then?
The views.
It's just the one thing putting me off is the second bedroom.
It's large enough for the two single beds for the kids.
Mm. Well, why don't you have that and they can have the larger bedroom?
The large bedroom's got aircon.
Well, look, you're in a great position.
Yeah.
Two great properties.
Yeah, I've wanted to be in this position, to be honest.
Once you've worked out what to do, give me a bell and we'll meet up, OK? Come on. If you'd like more information on any of the properties featured on today's show, go to aplaceinthesun.com/programme.
It's been an interesting search trying to find Danielle and Matt's dream holiday home. While they thought being closer to the sea was their top priority, they decided the size of the property itself was more important. And I have two brilliant ground floor apartments in the running. My second that they totally fell for, and my final property, which had the bonus of sea views, but was a little smaller inside. I can't wait to find out what they decided to do.
Morning, guys.
Morning.
How are you doing?
Very good.
Really well, yeah.
Fun search.
Yeah.
But a huge learning curve for the both of you,
lovely,
wasn't it?
Yeah, it made us realise what we wanted in the end, yeah.
Yeah. But you've never been here before.
We've really grown to love the place, haven't we? And we have, being with you, learned so much about it. And we've fallen in love with it, haven't we? Yeah. We really do like it here.
Rightfully so. It's gorgeous.
It is beautiful, yeah.
It's fantastic.
We're excited to hopefully be able to bring our families out here and show them around and enjoy it.
You must have had a tricky evening because, really, the dilemma for you both has been view versus interior space and that all-important second bedroom.
Yeah, it's for the girls, really. I mean,
we want to make a home from home from them and so they can just have time out in their bedroom and they've got to like it and we just didn't think they'd get the feeling.
I think we like the views, they wouldn't be fussed.
So, drum roll, have you come to a decision on what you want to do and which one of those has won over?
Yeah, we'd like to make an offer on the second property.
Brilliant. You know it's on the market for just over £91,500.
Yes.
We'd like to look about £86,000 for a starting point.
£86,000? Now, I think that's a really healthy offer, actually.
Yeah, hopefully.
Yeah. Shall I put a call and get this deal done?
Yes, get it done.
Yeah? You book your flights out next week?
I am planning to pack and come back next week, yes.
Are you?
Yeah, I'm here already.
Now, that is keen. I love it.
Very keen.
Good morning, Steve. I'm sat here with Matt and Danielle, and they would like to make an offer on the garden flat. They want to make you a very healthy cash offer of £86,000. They are champing at the bit to get this deal done and are willing to book flights back out next week to move in. Brilliant. And now we sit and wait, okay? No indication, I said they're very happy to get the deal done. He said, well, let's see if the vendors are just as happy. So we really don't know, but how are you feeling anyway?
Nervous.
Are you?
Yeah, I'm not expecting them to accept first offer at all.
No one would really.
Well, look, if they come back and it's a no and they don't give any other indication as to what their bottom line is, what are you inclined to do as a next step?
I'd go up to 87.
Yeah.
Do it a thousand
just
at a
little,
time.
Just a little nudge.
I think so,
yeah. Yeah, okay. Oh, here we go. We may just have an answer. Hello, Stephen. How did you get on? Okay. Right. Okay. I'm gonna mute you just a second and just run that past them. That's right, Stephen. They are saying to get the deal done right here, right now, they will take £87,500. I know you wanted to jump and have a thousand, it's another 1,500.
Can we do the deal with the furniture as well for that?
To include the furniture, should we say that?
Oh, that's pushing it a bit.
I think
let's try, but yeah, I'm happy with the price.
Stephen, if that includes the furniture, we have a deal. Okay. Thanks very much, Stephen. Speak soon. Bye. Yay! You've got a deal!
Already?
Yes! Was that too easy for you? Isn't that brilliant?
Really?
Obviously, in terms of the furniture, there's a few bits that they're going to want to keep, but mostly it's yours.
I knew you'd do this.
though.
I am so chuffed for you guys.
I thought it'd be a bit more difficult than that. Yeah.
Have you been worried? Have you been nervous about it?
I have, yeah.
Oh, fantastic. Look, big cheers. This is some
Thank
happy
you.
Holidays. Well, it looks like Matt and Danielle have fallen hook, line and sinker for this part of Spain and got themselves the most amazing apartment to boot. And I wish them and their family many happy holidays here in Almería.